In hindsight, I think it makes sense that I became a high school educator because I really had a great high school experience. I played a lot of sports, I was in clubs, I dabbled in student government a little bit. My senior year, I performed in two musicals. So I really relished high school. I really got into high school. It was a great experience. I have shared this with a number of people because I think it's a good story. I actually started at a community college, Ventura Community College, and played football there and then transferred to Sac State, Sacramento State, and played football there. Got a degree in history and my teaching credential at Sacramento State. Well, I don't know if I would use that word, but yeah, I worked the door at a couple of places and I worked concert security when I was very young, a young football player that wanted to earn extra money. And a lot of adventures is what I'll say, a lot of interesting adventures. I knew because of the high school experience I had, I have to couch that a little bit. In my first year at Ventura Community College, I had a mindset of being a business major and starting my own business. But after a few accounting classes, business classes, and history classes, I kind of went, well, wait a minute. I kind of don't like business, and I'm not doing that well in those classes. And I really do like history, and I'm doing really well in those classes. Coupled with just the coaching element and the athletic element, really, by the end of my freshman year in college, I knew I was going to be a teacher and a coach. I taught for 10 years, and I've been an administrator for 20 years, so 30 years altogether. I know I don't look that old. I've kind of traveled around. I went back to my high school and taught there for 4 years, and that was a great experience, going back and hanging out with my teachers and still calling them by their last name, you know, Mr. So-and-so and Mrs. So-and-so, and they would always yell at me and say, stop calling me that. You know, you're one of us now, just call me my first name. So I taught there for 4 years, and I moved to Aptos, California, in the Santa Cruz County area, and I taught there for 5 years, 5.5 years. And then I moved up here to Roseville, and I was an assistant principal at Wood Creek for 2 years. And then I went to Granite Bay High School and was an assistant principal there for 7 years, and then came back as principal here for the last 12 years. Ooh, that's a tough one. I think it's being able to collaborate with a lot of talented people, meaning our staff, and you know, I'm a tried and true athlete and team player, and I believe in that collaborative effort of reaching a particular goal. And so being a principal allows me kind of to be a head coach, if you will, of a large team. And our job and our goal is to provide the very best education that we can for young people. And if we all work together towards that goal, it's magical. I mean, when you look at the awesome things that are happening at Wood Creek High School, it's not because of me, it's because of everyone playing a part in making this school what it is. And that's neat. Always, it's a tough job, you know. When it comes down to it, I am responsible for everything. It is my job to make sure everything works on this campus. So when it doesn't work, I hear about it from a variety of input areas, from parents, from students, from my bosses, from teachers and staff. So that's the tough part, but it comes with the territory. You know, you take the highs and the lows together. So it's tough, but it's rewarding. I would say I think I brought an attitude of innovation. I think I encourage teachers and staff to try things and run with things. So a lot of the programs that have evolved over the years obviously happen because those people took them on. I think staying positive is a key to life. You know, you talked about challenges. I think I've written 3 letters of resignation in my 12 years here, and it was more out of frustration and just feeling like I was at wit's end, and it felt good just to get that out. But in reality, you know, sticking with the job and what my goal was and what I was trying to get to really showed me that being positive and supporting people in a positive way, you will get the outcomes that you usually want. There's so much. I would say there is a real genuineness to this school. There's not, I don't see it anyways. I don't see a lot of fakeness to the school. Whoever people are comfortable in their own skin. You know, when I am standing out there at lunch over the years and I'm seeing all the different groups of people, I see more cliques coming together, if you will, at times. And then, you know, they still exist. High school is partly that. But the crossover is amazing. You know, I'll say this. I was walking with a student about a week or so ago and taking them to, they had forgotten something somewhere or something like that. So I had to go open a door for them. And as I was walking, it was like two or three students walking with me. And another group of students walk by and say hello. And they say hello. And they go, oh, yeah, those are our so-and-so friends. But they compartmentalized them, but they also acknowledged that we're friends. We're all friends. But they're a different group. But we're all friends. And so that's really unique about Wood Creek High School, is how much people blend and how people genuinely care from a human aspect to one another. It's pretty impressive. Well, that's a great question, because I love it here, and I'm going to miss Wood Creek High School tremendously. I think part of it is trying to live a life that I encourage others to live and modeling that. So this was a great opportunity for me, and it's definitely going to be a challenge. And I kind of have been professing that to staff and students my whole career, that, you know, when challenges present themselves, when opportunities present themselves, you should go for it. You should, you know, try to strive for that next level of success, that next level of opportunity. And so one presented itself, and I thought, you know, if I don't get it, I'm fine. You know, if I didn't get the job, I'd end up staying the principal of Wood Creek High School. What a great place to be. But at the same time, I needed to go for it. And so I did. So my title is Assistant Superintendent of Curriculum Instruction. It's going to allow me to focus on the teaching side of education. You know, as the principal, I'm able to do that, but I'm also kind of a jack of all trades, because everything is my responsibility. So I know about grass, I know about turf, I know about, you know, all things related to this school, plumbing of all things. But this job's going to allow me to focus on the teaching side of education, and that's always been where my heart is. And hopefully I can make some positive impacts there. I am thrilled about getting back together with Ms. Hobbs, and I'm so thrilled that she was there a year ahead of me. So not unlike my transition to principal here, Ms. Hobbs was here, and she did a really good job of training me. So I expect the same when I head over to the district office. Well, I think that's one of the things that made me feel comfortable about moving on and taking another job, is I think Wood Creek has developed such a strong culture and such a strong direction that aside from, you know, the various changes that happen with classes that come and go, I think Wood Creek's on a very good trajectory, a very good path. So I don't see major changes happening in the next few years. You know, you never can tell beyond 5 years or so because of what happens in society and in educational law, et cetera. But I think Wood Creek's on a good path and probably will stay on it. You know, just be herself. She is fabulous. She's an outstanding educator, cares very deeply about this school, about students, about the staff. And I think, you know, her track record here with me as an assistant principal is for everyone to see. She's going to do a fantastic job. So my advice to her would be, when you get frustrated and you just can't take it anymore, write a letter of resignation and then burn it up and throw it away, because it'll all be fine.
It has been such a pleasure to work for Mr. Borhan as an assistant principal for the last 10 years. I'm really going to miss him. And when I think about the impact that he's made at Wood Creek High School, a lot of it's academic, although I think anybody that knows him knows how much he cares about the culture of the school and athletics and things like that. But in the last 10 years, I've seen our professional learning team movement be supported, really started and supported by him, classroom instruction, and because of that, we've seen growth in our advanced placement scores and the enrollment. We had API growth that was unmatched by those around us, and our A to G numbers have gone up significantly. He really left a mark on the academic part of Wood Creek. In terms of the mark he left on me, I will never be the same person. In a lot of ways, I'll never be the same leader in a lot of ways. The humble integrity that he shows so often is something that I really want to model in my life. In addition to that, one of the things I really respect about him is he makes the right decision, not necessarily the popular one. And he cares what people think and wants to collaborate, but he knows in the end sometimes he has to make the hard decision himself. So I'm really going to miss him. Know he's going to have an amazing tenure at the district office, and I know I have gigantic shoes to fill at Wood Creek High School.